Welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video tutorial, we will see the real building blocks of understanding Web API. So, before understanding Web API, we will try to understand what is a web. A web is nothing but an interconnected networks. For example, at location 1, you have several different computers. They are connected to each other by LAN wire. And at location B, you again have several different computers, and again they are connected to each other by several LAN wires. And at location C, you have several different computers, and again they are connected to each other by several LAN wires. So if you see, at location A, the computers are connected to each other, and location B, computers are connected to each other, and at location C, the computers are connected to each other. Web is nothing but connection of these interconnected networks. So if you are connecting between these three big networks, you call it a web. And what is an API? API stands for Application Programming Interface. So API means that you have a common set of definitions on how two different computers can interact with each other. For example, I may have one computer which is completely different platform and which is running on completely different technology from another computer which is running on completely different platform technologies altogether. So, how these two computers will communicate with each other? That is through an API. The third one is web server. Why we need web server? For example, we have the communication between a client and a server. The clients send the request, the server sends the response. But what is that software that interprets the client's request and prepares the response for the client? That software is your web server. And commonly used web server within the .NET world is IIS. The fourth one is why we need web API. Because we have distributed nature of applications. For example, I have a website that basically has one section is related to map, that is basically to tell my customers how to reach my physical location, and another particular place for customers to order my products on Amazon.com. So, I need to use Google Maps API to fetch the location, and I need to use Amazon's API to actually get the Amazon's resource. If you see here, even though my application is hosted at my server, basically I am using Amazon's API and Google's API. So, if you see, the software as an entirety is my software, Google software, and Amazon software. So, if you can understand this, this is the distributed nature of web applications, and that is very common in today's scenario. And if the software is distributed like this, we need a web API to communicate between these software applications so that we give a seamless final product to the end user. Thank you.
TutorialsPoint.com. Simply easy learning.